along with Dear Carl, standing on the 5-yard line, taking the season pickup.
Five of the 6 touchdowns tonight have all been on the ground. That just goes to show you the style of this game tonight. Sailors, meantime, get another good kick return. That was Garrett Hall with a nice return just past midfield. Twice now, the Sailors have gotten a good return out there. Time quarterback Cole Norris under center with eye formation, and a flag comes in. It's motion against the Sailors that will move them 5 yards back, so it's first and 15. This time Norris moves the shotgun. He's rolling left, he looks left, he dumps it left. Nice nifty move out there by number 7 Hall, but an even better tackle by the Mustangs at number 9. That's Dylan Tyree, one of the outside linebackers for the Mustangs. Mustangs showing blitz. They bring it, and down he goes. Guess who with the big play on defense? It's 51 Sonko with the sack. Third down and long for the Sailors. I love the energy that Sonko brings to this Mustangs defense. Meantime, that will end this quarter. And we are all set and ready for the fourth and final quarter of what has been an exciting football game, back and forth. Every time Newport Harbor goes up by a touchdown, the Mustangs march right back and bring this game close. Mustangs have never had the lead in this one, but they've been tied at 7s. Rest of the game, they've been down by either 8 or 1. Meantime, that is complete on the right-hand side. Nice hit out there by Harrison Morrow. And that helps keep the Sailors just shy. It's 4th and 1. They will go for it, or at least try to draw the Mustangs off sides. Mustangs do a good job of maintaining discipline. They do not jump, so the Sailors take a timeout. Of course, this is a big risk for the Sailors. Should they go for it and try to keep this drive alive? Or if they go for it and they don't get that first, the Mustangs will take over in great field position. It looks like the Sailors will play it safe, play the field position game. It does take a Sailor roll, so Sailor's coaching staff gets exactly what they wanted out of their kicking team. Meantime, Mustangs, 1st and 10, double tight end situation here, 1 running back. That is one thing the Mustangs haven't done differently tonight in the run game. Traditionally, they go with a lot of split-back formation with basically both Mills and Franklev as 2 tailbacks. Tonight, they have used Mills in a lot of situations at more of a true fullback type position. There you go. And speaking of, Mustangs get a good run up the middle there by Mills, following the lead block by the Mustangs number 66, Michael Roberts, the senior offensive lineman for the Mustangs, pushing forward, and Brandon Mills might as well grabbed a saddle because he just followed the trail that Roberts led there. Meantime, the Mustangs keep this one on the ground again. Franklin with the carry. It's going to bring up a 2nd down situation after the 4-yard run. Maybe 5 on the play. High formation. Briskin with the handoff. right up the middle again on the that I formation play. Now Mustangs starting to utilize both facets of that formation. All game long, they've been giving it to Frank Love on the tailback spot, but now with Mills at fullback, they have given him two runs on this drive alone, and he's gotten two Mustang first downs with it. Time Frank Love this time straight out the middle, uses that burst of speed, power, and a big hole by the Mustangs offensive line to get another big game. That time, Jimmy Malaya, number 70 for the Mustangs, with a key block. It's second and one. Mustangs not even disguising what they want to do with this drive here, as they've gone with a double tight end formation, yet they still throw out of it. It is Harrison Morrow with a catch, powering his way for a Mustangs first down. And we'll see you next week. We'll strike football!